Good morning, dear students. Today, I'm going to discuss about the topic matrices. What do you mean by a matrix? A matrix is a rectangular array of numbers or functions. You know the definition already. Next, you must know about order of a matrix. What do you mean by order of the matrix? What does it say? It says that to identify number of orders and number of columns, you need order of the matrix. Suppose order of the matrix is 2 by 3, it means that 2 rows and 3 columns. You know about equality of matrices. We say 2 matrices are equal if only they have same order and their corresponding elements are equal. I want to tell about types of matrix also. Let me go with row matrix. Row matrix means a matrix is said to be row matrix or row vector, or else you can say only row matrix if it has only one row. Similarly, a column matrix means if it has only one column. A matrix contains only one column, we call it as a column matrix. You can call one more type of matrix, that is singleton matrix, if a matrix has only one element. Next, you must know about null matrix or zero matrix, which is nothing but every element of a matrix is zero. If every element of a matrix is zero, we call it as null matrix or zero matrix. Next, I want to discuss about square matrix. Square matrix means if number of rows and number of columns are equal in a matrix, we call such matrix as square matrix. Okay, so square matrix means what? Number of rows is equal to number of columns. Say for example, I told number of rows is equal to number of columns. If I consider a matrix like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, minus 2, 0, minus 1. I have taken a matrix. So these are rows and these are columns, you know already. See, here number of rows is 3, number of columns also 3. So it is a square matrix. In square matrix, I want to tell few things. See here, these are called as diagonal elements of the square matrix. It is also called as principal diagonal elements. So, diagonal elements. Diagonal elements. One minute. Diagonal elements of A are 1, 6, minus 1. These are called as diagonal elements of A. Here only let me tell you about trace of matrix A. What do you mean by trace of matrix A? Trace of matrix A is nothing but sum of the diagonal elements. This is nothing but sum of the diagonal elements. Sum of the diagonal elements. For this matrix, trace of A is nothing but 1 plus 6 minus 1. Plus 1 minus 1 cancel. This is equal to 6. So trace of A is nothing but 6 here. This is how you have to find out trace of a matrix. Okay. Let me come back to types of matrix. So I was talking about square matrix. Now you know about diagonal elements also. Let me tell you about diagonal matrix. Diagonal elements of A are different. Diagonal matrix is different. We call a matrix as diagonal matrix. That means if you want to call a matrix as diagonal, it must be a square matrix. So a square matrix is said to be diagonal matrix if its non-diagonal elements are zero. For example, 1, 0, 0. For example, 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0.
0, 0, 0, 3.
Look at this. It is a square matrix where these are non-diagonal elements and all the non-diagonal elements are 0. Such a matrix is called as diagonal matrix. Suppose diagonal elements are equal. That is, if I write a matrix like this, this is, of course, diagonal matrix. We call it as scalar matrix also. Because every diagonal element are equal and it is equal to 2. That means, scalar matrix means what? A diagonal matrix is said to be scalar matrix if diagonal elements are equal. And that too, look at this one, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. This is known to everyone. It is called as identity matrix. So, a scalar matrix is said to be identity if diagonal elements are unity or else equal to 1. Then we call it as identity matrix. So, always, diagonal matrix, scalar matrix, identity matrix, or square matrix. Basically, a square matrix only can be diagonal matrix, a square matrix can be scalar matrix, a square matrix can be identity matrix. Okay, next thing. Next, I want to talk about in square matrix only, as I am discussing about types, let me discuss here only singular matrix and non-singular matrix. We call a matrix as singular. See, here also, this is also square matrix only, because if you want to talk about singular matrix, its determinant value must be 0. We call a matrix as singular matrix if its determinant value is 0. Now you know what you mean by determinant of matrix. So only I am talking about singular matrix. And if we call it as non-singular, if DPA is non-zero. Next, I want to talk about symmetric matrix, or else before symmetric matrix, let me tell you what you mean by transpose of a matrix. So transpose of a matrix is denoted by either A dash, or you can denote it by A transpose. So transpose is nothing but interchanging rows as columns, columns as rows. Say for example, I have a matrix 2, 3, 0, 1, 2 minus 2. Let me change the number as 12. Okay. So now, I want to write A transpose means. So you have to change rows as columns. That is 2, 3. Rows will become column. Or else you can say column will become row. So rows are interchanged as column. Column is interchanged as row. So, if the order of this matrix is 3 by 2, 3 by 2, then definitely its order is 2 by 3. Because rows and columns are interchanged, no? That's why. This is transpose of a matrix. Let us discuss about symmetric matrix. So, symmetric matrix means a square matrix A is said to be symmetric. See, if a matrix, you want to make a symmetric matrix means definitely it must be a square matrix. So we say a square matrix A is said to be symmetric if A is equal to A dash. After taking transpose, also if you get the same matrix, we call it as symmetric matrix. Let me give you one example. 1, 2, 3. 2, 4, 6, 3, 6, 5. Look at this. Let me call it as A. Let this is matrix A. Now I want to tell you, or else let me write what is A transpose. So here only I will write A transpose is equal to, this is row, no, I will write it as column 1 2 3, second row 2 4 6, third row 3 6 5. Okay, observe both the matrix. See, same 1 2 3 1 2 3 2 4 6 2 4 6 3 6 5 3 6 5. Such matrix are called as symmetric matrix. You can identify one more type also. So if you want to say symmetric matrix means, you just leave this diagonal elements. Forget this diagonal elements for a moment. If you fold this matrix through diagonal elements, like this if you fold, elements will overlap on the same elements. See here. Here also 2, 3 will overlap on 3, 6 will overlap on 6. Such matrix is said to be symmetric matrix. Okay, so let us discuss about skew symmetric. Let us discuss about skew symmetric matrix. A square matrix is said to be skew symmetric if A is equal to minus A dash. If A is equal to minus A dash. Let me give example here. So, A is equal to 0, 2, 3, minus 2, 0, minus 1, minus 3, 1, 0. Look at this. Okay, look at this. See, A is equal to minus A transpose. A is equal to minus A transpose. Let me write A transpose for this. A transpose is equal to 0, 2, 3, minus 2, 0, minus 1. Minus 3, 1, 0. What I will do? Let me take minus common from this matrix. Then it is 0, 2, 3, minus 2, 0, minus 1, minus 3, 1, 0. This is equal to minus. This matrix is nothing but our A only, no? A. So what is this? A transpose is equal to minus A. Here you can write A is equal to minus A transpose or minus A is equal to A transpose. Wherever you want, you can take minus that side. So this is about symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. Okay? Right. Let me go for operations on matrix. Let me go for operations on matrices. So, what are the operations are there in the matrix? We have addition of matrices, subtraction of matrices, scalar multiplication of a matrices, and matrix multiplication also there. So, let me take addition. How addition will be? If you want to do addition and subtraction, if you want to do addition or subtraction, so what is the condition? Order of the matrices must be same. If you want to add two matrix or if you want to subtract two matrices, condition is order of the matrices must be same. And how to operate that? Corresponding elements should be added or subtracted. Example I will show 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me take a matrix like this. And here it is. Let me write. Minus 2, 4, 6, and this is 3, minus 10, 8. I have written this. So if I add, if you want to add means, look at the order. Order must be same. How to do addition? Corresponding elements must be same. Okay. So add though both, 1 minus 2 is nothing but minus 1. 2 plus 4 is nothing but 6. 3 plus 6 is nothing but 9. 4 plus 3 is 7. 5 plus of minus is minus. 5 minus 10 is minus 5. 6 plus 8 is 14. This is how addition. And if you want to do subtraction. Then how to subtract this? So if I write minus. So this is 1. Minus into minus plus 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3. 2 minus 4. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. 3 minus 6 is minus 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. 5 minus into minus plus, 5 plus 10 is 15, 6 minus 8 is minus 2. This is how normal addition and subtraction of matrix will be there. Okay, then let me move for scalar multiplication of a matrix. Scalar multiplication of a matrix will be, let me take K is a scalar and A is a matrix. So how it will be? If you want to do scalar multiplication to a matrix means, you have to multiply that particular scalar to every element of the matrix. If you want example means, let me take 2 as the scalar and 1, 2, 0, 8. This is a matrix. Okay. So let me take this as matrix A and K is equal to 2. Suppose you want to write 2A. You want to write 2A. Then it is nothing but 2 into 1, 2, 0, 8. 2 need to be multiplied with every element of the matrix. So it is 2 into 1 is 2, 2 into 2 is 4, 2 into 0, 0, 2 into 8 is 16. This is how you have to go for scalar multiplication of a matrix. Scalar multiplication of a matrix. Now, if I want to talk about multiplication of two matrices, or else matrix multiplication, if I want to talk means, here order is very important. If you want to do matrix multiplication, then order is very important. Let me take a matrix A whose order is m by n. If you want to multiply any matrix to this matrix A, B, then definitely what must be the condition? This column must be row here. That is, number of rows must be n. Any number of column it can have. Let me take it as P. So this must be same. That is, number of rows of A, that is first matrix, whatever you choose as first matrix, is equal to number of columns of B, that is second matrix. Instead of A, you can take it as whatever you choose as first matrix, and here whatever you choose as second matrix. So if you want to do matrix multiplication means, what is our first condition? So number of rows of first matrix is equal to number of columns of second matrix. Then only matrix multiplication is possible. Otherwise, matrix multiplication is not possible. Is not possible. So you have to choose like that only. Fine. Now let me go for how to do that procedure also. Let me show you the procedure also once. Okay. Oh, look here. Let me take like this. Let me take a matrix. 2, 3, 4, 1, 0, minus 1. Tell me the order. 2 by 3. If you want to multiply means, another matrix must start with the 3 number of rows. Any number of columns it can have. So, let me take this as 1, 2, and minus 1, 0, minus 2, minus. I have taken like this. So, this is nothing but 3 by 2. So, what I told here, order must be like this. Then, resultant matrix will be of the order m by p. Resultant matrix will be the order m by p. So here also, see here, 3 and this is also 3. So resulting matrix will be of the order 2 by 2. Let me show you how does matrix multiplication can be done. So this is row, this is column. First row, first column. Look at the corresponding elements. Here I must not say corresponding elements. See, in row how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3. Here also 1, 2, 3. Multiply first element plus second element plus third element. So it is 2 into 1 is equal to 2. 3 into minus 1 is equal to minus 3. 4 into minus 2 is equal to minus 8. Now first column over, now take second column. So 2 into 2 is 4 plus 3 into 0 is 0. minus 4 into 3 is 12. Next, let me take second row. So 1 into 1 is 1, minus 0, minus into minus plus, 2 into 1 is 2. Now second column, 1 into 2 is 2, plus 0, minus into minus plus, 3 into 1 is 3. Simplify this. So this is 2 minus 3 is minus 1, minus 1 minus 8 is minus 9, 4 minus 12 is minus 8, 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 3 is 5. What is the order? It is 2 by 2. So as I said, so what was order of matrix A? Order of matrix A was 3 by 2. Order of matrix B was, what am I doing here? Sorry, look here. Order of matrix A is 2 by 3. B was 3 by 2. This must be same. So resulting matrix AB, you will get order 2 by 2, which we got 2 by 2. This is how you have to do matrix multiplication. Okay. Now let us move to properties of certain operations. Okay. First, let me take properties on addition. So, for addition, properties on addition of matrices. Okay. So, first is A plus B is equal to B plus A. That means addition of matrices holds good commutative property. Commutative property holds good on matrix addition. Second thing is, it also holds good for associative property. That is, A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Grouping is possible here. Third one is additive identity. For any matrix A, we will have a negative matrix, that is minus A, and minus A plus A, you are going to get a zero matrix. So we call minus A is additive identity of A. Existence of inverse is there. Here you see, additive identity means A plus 0 matrix is equal to 0 matrix plus A is equal to A. So we call 0 matrix as additive identity. We call 0 matrix as additive identity. And inverse exists in the addition. That is, additive inverse is possible. For every matrix A, negative A, that is minus A. So A plus of minus A is equal to minus A plus A is equal to additive identity. So you are going to get 0 matrix. So we call minus A as additive inverse of A. Reverse also correct. A is additive inverse of minus A. These are properties of matrix addition. And properties of scalar multiplication of a matrix is, so let me take K is a scalar, A is a matrix, A and B is a matrix. So you can write K into A plus B is equal to KA plus KB. You can take K into A plus B is equal to KA plus KB. Also, whenever necessary, if K and L are scalars and A is a matrix, you can take this as KA plus LA. This is properties of scalar multiplication of a matrix. Next, if I come to properties of matrix multiplication. So, if I come to properties of matrix multiplication, then matrix multiplication generally does not follow commutative property. That is, AB is not equal to BA. Generally, AB is not equal to BA. And also, before that, I want to make a note here. See here. See, AB is equal to 0 matrix is possible. In real numbers, you might be knowing this. X into Y is equal to 0 implies X is equal to 0 or Y is equal to 0 or both X, Y are zeros. Correct? If you multiply two numbers and the resultant is 0, then definitely one number will be 0 or both the numbers are 0. But it is not correct in matrix. Suppose multiplication of two matrix is a 0 matrix, then it need not imply A0, B0. So here it may be A is non-zero, B is non-zero matrix. I'll show example here only. Let me take a matrix 0, 0, 1, 2 and 3, 4, 0, 0. Let me multiply these two. Possibility is there because both are square matrix. Need not worry about order of the matrix. So let me take the product. 0 into 3 is 0. 1 into 0 is 0. Now you see 0 into 4 is 0. 1 into 0 is 0. 0 into 3 is 0. 2 into 0 is 0. Similarly, here also 0. This is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0. It can be represented like this as a 0 matrix. So what was my matrix A? Let me take this as matrix A. A is equal to 0, 0, 1, 2. This is a non-zero matrix. We have taken B is equal to 3, 4, 0, 0. This is also non-zero matrix. What we got? We got AB is equal to 0. But here A is a non-zero matrix as well as B is a non-zero matrix. Okay? Right. Let me move for next property. Next property of matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication follows associative property. That is, AB into C is equal to A into BC. I told it generally does not follow commutative property, but it follow associative property. And it follow distributive property. That is, A plus B into C is equal to AC plus BC. AC plus BC. Also, one more is A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. AB plus AC. Then what about identity element for matrix multiplication? Only square matrix will have identity element. Then what will be that identity element? Let me show you what will be that identity element. So that identity element is nothing but, should get like this now. See, A multiplied with some matrix is equal to some matrix is multiplied with A. You must get A as the answer. Then only you can call this matrix as identity element. Okay. So what I told, only square matrix will have identity element. Let me take a square matrix. Let me check with A is equal to 2 minus 3 minus 8, 10. Then this is the matrix. Okay, so what I will do, let me take identity matrix. You know this, no? Identity matrix, whatever the order here, same order I have taken. Let us do AI. What happens with AI? Let us do matrix multiplication. 2 into 1 is 2 minus 0. Second column, 2 zeros are 0 minus 3. This minus 8 plus 0. Next 0 plus 10. How much it is? 2 minus 0 is 2 minus 3 minus 8, 10. This is nothing but A, no? A. So IA also you can do. IA if you want to do means. So if you want to do IA means row, you should take column. 1 into 2 is 2, 0. Next row, column. So 1 into minus 3 is minus 3 plus 0. Second row, first column, 0 into 2 is 0. Second row, so minus 8. Next, second row, second column, 0 plus 10. So this is equal to 2 minus 3, minus 8, 10. This is our A. So what I got? A into I is equal to, I into A is equal to A. That's why we say only square matrix will have identity element. These are properties of matrix multiplication. Properties of matrix multiplication. Let me discuss properties of trace of a matrix. Let me discuss properties of trace of a matrix. You remember, no? Trace of a matrix is nothing but sum of diagonal elements we call as trace of a matrix. We have few properties on trace of a matrix also. Let me discuss about that. So, first thing is trace of A is equal to trace of A dash. Also, trace of lambda A, where lambda is constant, is equal to lambda into trace of A. Trace of AB is equal to trace of BA. Here only let me make you clear. Trace of AB is not equal to trace of A into trace of B. Idu possible illa. This is possible. Trace of AB is equal to trace of BA. Where trace of AB is never equal to trace of A into trace of B. Okay. Next is trace of identity matrix is equal to N. Whatever the order of identity matrix will be there, no? That itself will be the 3 by 3 identity. The trace will be 3. Like that. Okay. Next, trace of 0 matrix will be 0. Trace of 0 matrix will be 0. These are properties of trace of a matrix. Okay. Now, let us go for properties of transpose of a matrix. Properties of transpose of a matrix. See, in transpose also, A dash whole dash is equal to A. Properties of transpose of a matrix. A dash whole dash is equal to A. A plus B whole dash is equal to A dash plus B dash. A minus B whole dash is equal to A dash minus B dash. AB whole dash is equal to B dash A dash. These are properties of transpose of a matrix. Properties of transpose of a matrix. Okay. See, actually I did not discuss about inverse element of matrix multiplication. Now let me discuss about inverse of matrix multiplication. While discussing about properties of matrix multiplication, I stop at identity element only. Okay. Now let me tell you, what do you mean by inverse of a matrix multiplication? Suppose AB is equal to BA is equal to I, if it is possible. Already you know, generally AB is not equal to BA. Already you know this. Now I am telling, if AB is equal to BA is possible and is equal to identity matrix, then we say that A inverse is equal to B. Then we say that A inverse is equal to B. This is definition of inverse of a matrix. Inverse of a matrix. In this also we have properties. The property is AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse, A inverse. Most important property, we use this. So AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse, A inverse. So this is about properties of matrices. That means properties in different category. That is addition, multiplication, transpose, trace of a matrix. In all those, I have given how it will be. Okay. Next thing what I want to discuss with you is, see, in inverse, I want to tell about this.
Suppose you have a diagonal matrix. A 0 0 0 B 0 0 0 C. You know, this is a diagonal matrix. If you have a diagonal matrix and det A is a non-zero, det A is non-zero, then its inverse is given by A inverse is given by 1 by A 0 0 0 1 by B 0 0 0 1 by C. Question will come on this. They will give diagonal matrix and they will ask its inverse. So if it is diagonal matrix, you can remember this as formula. So these are about some formulas. Now let me go for problematic part of matrices. Look here. I have written few questions in which, see here. First question, they have given a matrix like this. And they are asking which type of matrix is this. See, scalar. To observe scalar, diagonal elements are important. 0 is there, 5 is there. Not possible. Diagonal. See, non-diagonal element must be 0. Whether you want to take it as scalar matrix or diagonal matrix, definitely non-diagonal elements must be 0. But 5 is there. Therefore, scalar diagonal ruled out. Row matrix means what? Only one row must be there. That is also not possible. Therefore, it is square matrix. Because you see, number of rows is equal to number of columns. Look at second question. They are asking, suppose A and B are square matrices. And what is this? In the option, they have given something and all. Let me multiply and show you. You know this already. A plus B into A minus B. Let me multiply with A. What you will get? A into A is A square minus A into B is AB plus. From B, let me start. It is BA plus into minus minus B square. This will be your answer. You can never cancel AB and BA in matrix because already you know the thing. AB and B are not equal. AB is not equal to BA. Therefore, you cannot cancel this. Therefore, this must be the order. Okay? Right. Next, look at this. Number of possible matrices of order 3 by 3 with each entry 2 and 0. See, for this, observe 3 by 3 matrix means how many elements will be there in the matrix? 9 elements. 2 and 0 means what are the possible number of entries? 2 possible number of entries. So, for this formula is number of options whole to the power number of elements in the matrix. Number of elements in the matrix. So number of options, how many are there? 2 is one option, 0 is another option. So number of option is 2. Number of elements in the matrix, how many are there? 9. Therefore 2 power 9 is our answer. 2 power 9 means how much here? Here it is 512. Okay. Look at this one. What they are asking you, A and B are symmetric, that is A and B are symmetric matrices, then what is this A dash B minus B A dash? Option is, they are asking it is also symmetric, skew symmetric, null matrix or none of the above. Okay, so to decide symmetric or skew symmetric, let me show what I will do is, let me take C is equal to A dash B. What I want to do is, let me take like this. 1 minute. Let me take C is equal to what they have given. A dash B minus B A dash. I have taken like this. Now, let me apply transpose on both sides. So, A dash B minus B A dash whole dash. I have applied transpose on both sides. Then C dash is equal to, subtraction is there. Therefore, it is A dash B whole dash minus B A dash whole dash. This is equal to. So you know this property. A B whole dash is equal to B dash A dash. Therefore first I have to take B. So it is B dash. A dash whole dash is A. You know this already. A dash whole dash is equal to A. Therefore it is going to become B dash. A dash whole dash is A minus this A dash whole dash is A and this is B dash. Okay.
Now this is C dash. What I want to do is from this term, let me take minus common. See, when you get this, observe this and this. Both are not same, no? When both are not same, take minus common. If I take minus common, it is AB dash minus, it is AB, what is there here? It is B dash A, it is A dash B. Oh, I have written both the same. One minute. Let me check the question again. Give me 1 minute. What they have given is, it is AB dash BA dash. It is 1 minute. I'm sorry. AB dash. It is like this. AB dash minus BA dash. Therefore, it is AB dash. It is AB dash. So, you have to change here. Let me change this. So, what you are going to get here? Let me take transpose. So, C dash is equal to AB dash minus BA dash whole dash. So, C dash is equal to AB dash whole dash minus BA dash whole dash. So, according to transpose, AB whole dash is B dash A dash, no? So, this will come first. So, B dash whole dash is B and this is A dash minus. This is A, B dash. A dash whole dash is A, B dash. Now, you see here, this and this are not equal. When it is not equal, take minus common. If I take minus common, what happens here? It is AB dash minus BA dash. So, C dash is equal to this minus. This is nothing but our C only. If C dash is equal to minus A, we call it as skew symmetric matrix. If C dash is equal to C, you have to call it as symmetric. If C dash is equal to minus C, it is skew symmetric matrix. Okay. See these questions. What they have given you? Equals is there. Two matrix are there. You need to compare and you need to answer. See, first you look at the options. When XY values are given, nowhere it is like unable to find out, not possible to find out. Athara enu illa. At that time what you do? Wherever it is easy to find out the value, those values you take. Or else go for option verification. What I do? I'll take this. If I take that, what happens? Let me answer here. 4x is equal to x plus 6. Correct? 4x is equal to x plus 6. X bring this side. 3x is equal to 6. X is equal to 2. See, you have only two options. X is equal to 2. So, what I will do? Again, let me go somewhere. Wherever you want, there you can go. Let me take this now. Because you know x is equal to 2, no? Substitute here. 5x minus 7 is equal to y. 2 if I substitute, 10 minus 7, 3. So, x is equal to 2, y is equal to 3 will be our answer. See, here what they are asking you, they have given a and they are asking you a square. In options, they have given what are a square. If you want a square means you have to do a into a. So, a square means a into a, that is 0, 1, 1, 0 into 0, 1, 1, 0. So, how to do? Row, column. 0 into 0 is 0 plus 1 into 1 is 1. Row, second column. 0 into 1 is 0 plus 0 into 1 is 0. Next, second row, first column. 1 into 0 is 0 plus 0 into 1 is 0. Second row, second column. 1 into 1 is 1 plus 0. So, if you simplify, it is 1, 0, 0, 1. This only they have given. In options, different matrix given. Wherever this is there, that you can answer. Okay? Look at 7th question. In 7th question, they have given two questions. What are the two matrix they have given? See, A is equal to 1 by pi. Sin inverse x pi, tan inverse x by pi, sin inverse x by pi, cot inverse pi x.
And B also they have given. B is equal to 1 by pi minus, this is cos inverse, minus cos inverse x pi, tan inverse x by pi, sin inverse x by pi, minus tan inverse pi x. What is their question? They are asking you, find A minus B. They are asking, A minus B they are asking, and options they have kept. A minus B is equal to what? This is the question. So, if you want to do A minus B, condition is there, no? That is, order must be same. Corresponding elements you have to do. So, look here. If you want to do A minus B means, instead of taking 1 by pi inside the matrix, let me take 1 by pi common. Okay? If I take 1 by pi common, what is left? Here, sin inverse x pi minus into minus plus cos inverse x pi. Next, tan inverse x by pi minus tan inverse x by pi will be 0. Tan inverse x by pi minus tan inverse x by pi will be 0. Next, you see this. Sin inverse x by pi minus sin inverse x by pi also 0. Next, this term, that is cot inverse pi. Cot inverse pi x. Now, minus into minus, see, minus into minus plus tan inverse pi x. Plus tan inverse pi x. Okay. So, this is equal to 1 by, this is equal to 1 by pi. You know this. In inverse trigonometric functions, you have this formula. Sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. See, look here. Both the angles are same. Therefore, this is going to become pi by 2, 0, 0. Here also you see tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. But here you have cot inverse pi x plus tan inverse pi x. Angles are same. Therefore, that is also pi by 2. Can I take pi by 2 outside? If I take pi by 2 outside, it is 1 by pi into pi by 2, 1, 0, 0, 1. Pi, pi cancels. This is equal to half into, 1 by 2 is left, no? Half into, this is identity matrix. So, let me write I. Okay, in the options, how they have given? 2i, I, 1 by 2i, pi by 2i. Like this, they have given option. So, we have 1 by 2 into I will be our answer. Okay. Look here. They have given, if trace of A is equal to 6, then trace of 4A. We know the property. What is the property known to us? We know this thing. See, trace of lambda A is equal to lambda into trace A. So, this is going to become 4 into trace A. So, that is 4 into 6, which is equal to 24. In the options, they have given numbers. Look at this. If A is equal to this much, then they are asking what is A power 4. Okay. Look here carefully. It is a scalar matrix. Correct? It is a scalar matrix. If it is a scalar matrix, I will give you one formula. Or else, let me show you A square. Let me show you A square. What will come? So, it is A square is nothing but A into A. So, it is 2, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 2, 2, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 2. Okay, look here. So, how much it is? 2, 2 is a 4. 2, 2 is a 4. Next, anyhow, 0 will come. 0, 0. Next, second let me take. So, 2 into 0, 0, 0, 0 will come. If you multiply, you will get it. Second row. 0, 2 is a 0, 0, 0. 0, 2, 2 is a 4, 0, 0, 0, 2, 2 is a 4. Okay, like this it is going to come. That means, if I take 4 outside, if I take 4 outside, it will become 1, 0, 0, 1. Like this it is going to become. That is nothing but 4 into I. Correct? Or else, if I take 2 outside, if I take 2 outside, it is going to become 2, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 2. Okay? So this is going to become 2a. Sorry, this is going to become 2a. So what I want to give you formula is, suppose A is a scalar matrix. It is only for scalar matrix. If A is a scalar matrix, then A power any number p, let me take A power p is equal to, see here, what was there? Here 4 was there, or else A power p is equal to, you are going to get, let me write, A is scalar means what it is. See, I want to tell like this. See here, A power 4 is there, no? What was the scalar here? 2 is the scalar. You are going to get 2 cube into A. You are going to get 2 cube into A. Here 4 is there means like this it is. Suppose here lambda is there means you are going to get lambda to the power 3 into A. Here P is there means P minus 1. Okay? P minus 1 into A will come. So, see here. If they give like this, these two are same questions only. Instead of giving like this, they have given diagonal 3, 3, 3. That means remaining elements are 0. Again, A power 4, they are asking. What is there in the diagonal element? 3. 4 minus 1 is also 3 into A. 3 cube into A. That is nothing but 3 cube is 27A. Here it is going to become 2 cube is 18. I hope you understood. Okay. Let me take the 11th question. What they are asking in the 11th question? In the 11th question, they are asking, they have given A. They told A square is equal to I. Find X. A square means X 1, 1, 0 into X 1, 1, 0 is equal to identity. So 1, 0, 0, 1. Go for multiplication. Don't do everywhere. Just take one element. That will be sufficient for us. So, if I do like this, it is x into x, x square plus 1. Whatever the element here, let us not bother for that. Whatever it might be. So, equate. So, it is x square plus 1 equal to 1. 1, 1 cancels. X square equal to 0. X equal to 0. Don't multiply all the elements. It is not required. Because they are asking only x value, no? So, no need to find out every element. Just find out only one element where you get x. You can equate. You are going to get the value of x. This is how you have to find this. 12th one. Matrix Mn into multiplication it is equal to 25. M less than n. What is Mn they are asking? Of course, if you solve this matrix, row column, you will get M square plus n square. Is equal to 25 you will get. You know, 4 square plus 3 square is 25, or 3 square plus 4 square is also 25. But they are telling you M is less than N. Therefore, 3, 4 will be answer. 9 plus 16 is 25. Look at this. A is a matrix they have given. A power N is equal to 0. They are only telling A power N is equal to 0. Minimum value of N is, for so many numbers, A power something is equal to 0 you are going to get. But they are asking what is minimum value of N. So to find minimum value, let me start with A square only. Let me find A square. A square is A into A. That is AB, B square minus A square minus AB. AB, B square minus A square minus AB. Do multiplication. So it is AB into AB is A square B square minus A square B square. So AB into this one, AB into B square is AB cube, this one. So it is minus AB cube. Both the elements we are getting 0. Now minus A cube B and this plus A cube B. Last one, this. It is minus A square B square, this plus A square B square. So this is equal to, every term getting cancelled, you are getting 0 matrix. Okay. So if I take 2 itself, you are getting 0. So definitely A is not equal to 0. Minimum value of N is equal to 2. Look at this.
they have given something like this. A into some matrix is equal to, they have given answer. They are asking you to find out A. For this, no actual procedure. So what you have to do is, go for option verification. How? So let me take first option. First option, what you have? 1, 1, 2 minus 3 into, so what is there? Minus 1, 2, 3, 1. Go for matrix multiplication. So 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. So 3 into 1 is 3. What is this? Minus, something will be there here. 3 minus 1 is 2, no? But first you must get minus 4. So leave, this is not our option. Take, so therefore 1, 1 is there means we are not going to get first element. So leave. Option A cancelled, ruled out. Option B also ruled out. I am forced to take option C. So if I take option C, it is 1, minus 1, 2, 3. And here you have minus 1, 2, 3, 1. Go for multiplication, then it is 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Minus 1 into 3 is minus 3. Minus 1 minus 3 is minus 4. Okay. So, this is our suitable option. You know, since AB can never be equal to any other. If you have doubt, you can check this also. If it is minus 1, 1, minus 1, 3, how does it go? Minus 1 into 1 is 1. 3 into 1 is 3. It will become 4. But you must get minus 4. Therefore, option C is our answer. Look at the last question. A is equal to, see, as I told you, if it is a diagonal matrix and det A not equal to 0, A inverse can be written as 1 by 9, 0, 0, 0, 1 by 10, 0, 0, 0, 1 by 8. Students, matrices will be a easy topic for you. You will never lose marks in this. Including matrices and determinants, you are going to get 5 questions. Sometimes matrix 3, determinants 2. Sometimes reverse. Matrix 2, determinants 3. Like that they are going to ask. Together matrices and determinants, you are going to get 5 questions. Be careful while answering this. Sometimes you can choose option verification. Sometimes you can choose actual procedure. Go through the formulas and answer the questions. Thank you.